All right, we're back to the pool, and the next final is the men's 200-meter breaststroke final. The Olympic record is still held by David Wilkie of Great Britain. It was set in Montreal in 1976. The world record is held by a man you'll see in the pool in just a moment, Victor Davis of Canada. He is from the town of Etobicoke, Canada. He set this particular world record on June 19 of this year, 2 minutes, 14 and 58, 100 seconds, though he broke it for the first time at the World Championship in 1982. And over the past 2 years, Victor Davis has dominated the 200-meter breaststroke on an international level. But in a major surprise today, he did not qualify as the leading qualifier into this field. In fact, a 19-year-old Australian named Glenn Berengen, who ranked 20th in the world a year ago, qualified a second and a half ahead of Victor Davis. More on that in a moment, but first, we remind you about Alex Bauman, the Canadian who won the 400-meter individual medley earlier in these Olympics. You'll remember that that was the first gold medal for Canada in swimming in 72 years. Minutes later, Ann Ottenbright won a second one, and now Davis is favored to win a third. Like Bauman, he has a tattoo of a maple leaf on his chest. Like Bauman, he is a bit of an individualist. He is best known in Canada for the criticism he received following the 1982 Commonwealth Games after he kicked a chair on the deck after Canada's medley relay was disqualified. The action took place directly in front of Queen Elizabeth. There is Alexander Yokochi of Portugal, 19 years old, not in the top 25 in the world a year ago, but he followed Richard Schroeder of the United States in a heat to qualify. And there is Richard Schroeder, one of the great late bloomers of all time. 2 years ago, he didn't rank in the top 100 in the world. Last year, he swam in his first national meet at age 21. Now here he is in an Olympic final. In lane three, Marco Del Prete, 18 years old from Italy, not in the top 25 in the world a year ago, but he set a new Italian record in this morning's trials. He will be swimming in lane three. Lane four, this is the man who emerged as the favorite for the silver medal this morning, Glenn Berengen, 19 years old from the town of Adelaide in Australia, 20th in the world a year ago, but coming up very big in 1984, and he will be swimming in lane four. Lane five, Victor Davis, world record holder, 82 world champion. Already in these Olympics, he has a silver medal in the 100-meter breaststroke behind Steve Lundquist of the United States. And in that race, he showed more speed than he has demonstrated before as he followed Lundquist to a time under the previous world record. In lane six, Etienne Degan, 23 years old from Biel, Switzerland, failed to reach the finals in the 100-meter breaststroke, typically his best event, but now, surprisingly, he has made it to the finals in the 200-meter event. Lane seven, Ken Fitzpatrick, 21, from London, Ontario, Canada, recorded a personal record of 2:19.74 in the trials this morning, and he swims for the University of Southern California, so he will be swimming in this pool in the fall as he continues to train with the USC team. In lane eight, Paolo Restrepo, 24 years old from Colombia. The biggest accomplishment of his career was a second-place finish in the Pan Am Games in Caracas a year ago in his home country of Colombia. We're going to get a look right now at John Moffitt, the American who is disappointed not to be in this race. He was second at the United States Olympic trials earlier in the meet. You saw him finish fifth in the 100-meter breaststroke, swimming with a badly strained groin muscle, and he is unable to compete for the rest of the games. And there you look down from our helicopter shot at the packed house here at the Olympic Swimming Stadium, where competition has been tough, intense, dominated by Americans, but it would be a shock if American Richard Schroeder won this race.
It's very unfortunate that John Moffitt had his groin injury, and Fédération Internationale Natation Amateur, FINA, which is our governing body in swimming, does not provide for a substitute for sickness or injury, and thus no American was substituted for him. That's the reason we don't find two Americans in this event. However, Richard Schroeder for the United States will be swimming in lane number two, and he's moved out to an early lead.
The United States would certainly have loved to substitute Steve Lundquist into this event. He's one of only a handful of men in history ever to go under 2:16, but he can't do it, as Mark Spitz told you. As they turn at 50 meters, it is Davis in the lead. He is taking command over Berengen as if to teach the young man a lesson, and he's under his own world record pace after 50 meters. The man who's staying with him up in lane two in the white cap is Richard Schroeder of the United States, who went out so hard in 100 meters this morning, he was way under world record pace.
Well, I think he's going just a little bit slower than he did in the preliminaries because he died in the final meters. He's maybe going out a little bit too slow, however. But Victor Davis of Canada looks exceptionally strong right now at the 100 meters mark. He can go into the turn. He's underneath the world record pace at this moment in time. You're allowed to take a kick underwater and break the service. Unlike other strokes, the breaststroke is subject to so many rules and qualifications so that you become legal. And it's very important that you don't put your head underwater. You can see the breaststroke has an arm recovery and kick all underwater. The only thing that must remain above the surface at all times is the head.
Davis is swimming with a vengeance. Clearly, he was holding back in qualifying this morning. He's three body lengths ahead of Berenson, who has now moved into second place. Schroeder is beginning to back off a little bit, as perhaps the first 100 meters was a little too much for him. The question now, will Victor Davis break his own world record of 2:14.58? You are looking at one of the most talented swimmers in the world today.
He has such a powerful stroke. He's moving so decisively away from the field. He's just built his pace continually throughout the 50-meter marks, and right now it looks as though he's going to break a world record. It's a question of what his time will be. The time of 2:14.58 is that mark.
Talk about a comeback. Victor Davis missed all last year with a case of mononucleosis. He dropped 101st in the world. Now he is reestablishing his dominance. He touches in 2:13.34, crushing his previous world record by a second and 2,400. Second place went to Berenson of Australia. Third place went to Etienne Degan of Switzerland. And that is an upset and a tremendous thrill for Degan. Richard Schroeder of the United States faded to finish fourth. That is the third Canadian gold medal, the seventh medal for Australia. You see John Moffitt applauding Davis's effort as he gets a handshake from a man next to him who is consoling him on his absence from that race. But let's take a super slow-mo look. Mark Spitz at Victor Davis.
You can see right here how powerful he is within his stroke. He comes up a little bit high, but he's got so much power in his stroke as he comes underneath his shoulders. There you can see the underarm recovery, extremely streamlined, must remain streamlined. Otherwise, he gets forces against them which will slow him down. There, a beautiful shot of his strong, whipping type of a breaststroke kick. Much faster than other breaststrokers. It almost appears when he kicks the frog kick that he's doing a dolphin kick because it whips back so quickly.
So make it two gold medals for the Maple Leaf Tattoos. And in the next event, we'll be coming back here for the women's 100-meter breaststroke. Ann Ottenbright, the other Canadian who won a gold medal, will have another shot. So we'll try to get a word with Victor Davis as you look once again at the final results. Davis, Berenson, and Degan. We'll be back. Now we are back live at the pool where just moments ago, Victor Davis of Canada absolutely obliterated his previous world record in the men's 200-meter breaststroke, breaking it by far more than a second, and he's standing by now with Diana Nya. Diana?
Victor, an inspirational swim to watch someone who knows their pace so well, and you built that race beautifully. Were you thinking clock before you went in, or strictly the other swimmers in the pool in the medal?
Well, after this morning's swim, I was a little not really scared, but worried about my swim because of the way I felt, and my time was not exactly as I wanted to go. I wanted to go 16, and I went 18. But, you know, I talked to my coach, and we worked in warm-up, and, you know, it just came together really well, so I went out a little fast, though.
Do you think after you're breaking the world record in the 100 behind Steve Lundquist, you proved to yourself that you had some more exceptional speed than you knew, and you went out here fast because of that?
I think my coach and I both knew that, you know, a 101.9 was in my blood, but, you know, I mean, I think also I could have went faster if I was beside Steve in the 100, but, you know, it's handy, since I'm a 200er, to have the speed to go out. It doesn't hurt you as much.
I think when the people at home see a world record shattered like that, they probably wonder just how ambitious a young man like you is. Do you have any predictions on where that record is going to fall to while you're swimming?
Well, you know, I think it's going to fall again. Maybe twice, three times to me, once more. I'm not finished with it yet. I have to try, and my coach and I have a goal is to set it away so that, you know, no one can touch it for a few years like David Wilkie did with the breaststroke in 76. You know, I broke it 6 years later, which is, you know, it's quite a long record. So we're going to try and do that also.
Well, I'd say it's just about there now. Congratulations. Back to you, Jim.
You would have to believe that he has a chance to do exactly that, and there'll be no chairs kicked over here today. Jim McKay?